This was that Mercury comet that has been sitting in the back of my head on the back burner forever. This thing was buried in the bush, well, in the thicket. We were not able to pull it out. Look at, there's no floor right here. And basically now it's dry enough that we can actually get back there. So in November, we ran into some bad wet ground, and you get stuck like nothing right here. But luckily, it came out of its grave. It was in there really well. What a battle it was to get it out. And the hood was down in the ravine over there, but ultimately, I got it out. Oh, look, there's the jack. Some scrap metal. But now, yeah, it would have made a pretty good video, but man, it is really stifling hot. It looks like something got killed here. So apparently there's a DeSoto down here, so I'm gonna go take a look at that. There's some wild raspberries there. Let's see what we're dealing with. It's like somebody's already walked by back here. It is probably 42 degrees with the Humidex. It is hot. Oh, there it is. That's the DeSoto. You can just see the front of it. Oh. So that comet, I know it looks like a heap of garbage, but man, it was actually, the comet was the 65 comet that we parted out. I did pretty well on it. Wow, look at the tree. How am I gonna get that out? That's gonna be a little tricky to get out. Oh boy. So this one's gonna be a little difficult to get out of the way. Alright, snapped a picture there from my Instagram. Yep, I'm on Instagram now. I was forced to go to another platform. Not that I wanted to do that. I've got no time as it is already, and this just sucks even more time. But oh, so no rims and tires on this guy. Luckily, it's a little drier back here. But there's the drive shaft down there. There's some stainless steel trim. The doors are open on the other side. Man, I wonder what engine's in this thing. We'll just put this there. We'll save that for later. Oh, it looks like a slant. Probably just a six-cylinder, something like that. Doesn't look like anything special. But yeah, the tree is gonna be it's gonna pose a problem. That's for sure. Wonder how long it sat back here. Oh. So yeah, the owner said that he's gonna move this brush all out of the way and whatnot. So I don't know what year this is, but I don't know DeSoto's that well. Well, this is going to be pretty tricky to get out. It's going to be pretty difficult. But I'm up for, it's a Studebaker. unless he meant there's another car here somewhere too. Oh man, he called it a DeSoto. Here I was getting all excited. Well, this is going to be a little bit of a challenge to get this out. But you know what? I think it'll be a fun job to do. Let's see what we can do. Yeah, Studebaker. Not too many of those around anymore. But I'm excited. I think I'm up for the challenge. Hopefully the risk versus reward is there, and we'll We'll have to get the tractor down here to get this like a pathway cleared out, kind of like we did over here. We had to get all the, there's a whole bunch of stuff in the way, and this is where we had that truck that we cut the frame in half and pulled that out. So I'm gonna leave my one car here and I'm gonna take home the hot rod, but here's the 1970s plates, and he figures since 75, 77 that it's been back here. Tighten up this chain here, as if I slam on the brakes, it's gonna wanna go forward. I had to wrap the chain around this whole body, and otherwise the car would have split in two. And then the rear end already stayed in one spot, and it was a bit of a battle to get it out, but we persevered and got it out. So it's a good day.